Management is the activities required for planning, organizing, leading and controlling. Consisting of these activities, there are many different approaches, and these approaches has not been developed in one day. In this video, we are going to see different developments of major management approaches. Let's look at this. Development of management approaches. It has a very big historical background, and this historical background included early examples of management that I am going to serve you very soon, and where Adam Smith and different industrial revolutions contributed. And based on these facts, early management practices, Adam Smith's contribution to the general management and industrial revolution, many different approaches are developed, and those approaches are scientific management approach, general administrative theories and related approaches, quantitative approach. In addition to that, there are another three: organizational behavioral approach, system approach and contingency approach. So if we list all those approaches, at first we have to find out the background, and from this first part of background, what are the contribution in ancient period? Management has not evolved in one or two or last 400 or 500 years. It has a very root in 10,000 years back activities. And if I present some examples, those may be Egypt, that we call pyramids of Egypt, and Great Wall of China. This big and gigantic task cannot be developed without the task of management. And as we know, the pyramids are built from the large number of stones, where people work for 20 years, and this gigantic task can't be possible without the touch of management. So that's why we can say there are some management approaches in those ancient management periods. And also in recent history, India's Taj Mahal, it is also a very gigantic task, where the concretes came from a very large distance. So that's why ancient management period has a very big contribution to the evolving history of management. Next, Adam Smith's contribution. Adam Smith has written a book that is named as The Wealth of Nations in 1776. And in this book, he advocated that the division of labor, that indicates the job specialization, to increase the productivity of the workers. Based on these theories, concepts and activities, Adam Smith contributed to the foundation of management. Next, we can knock in the Industrial Revolution period. Industrial revolutions are the basic backbone of today's modern society, because due to this revolution, we are now mechanized and robotic world, and these industrial revolutions substituted the machine power for human labor. Also, this industrial revolution created large organization in need of management. Let's look for part B, major approaches to management. As we have already seen in the picture, that six management approaches: scientific management, general administrative, quantitative management approach, organizational behavioral approach, system approach and contingency approach. Now we are looking a brief summary on these major approaches to management. So first one, scientific management approach. F.W. Taylor is the father of the scientific management approach. So basically, what scientific management indicates? Scientific management can be defined that one best way is the best practice approach for doing any particular work. And if you want to do any work, do not depend on only your mere judgment. Go for scientific calculation and find out one best way and solve those problems. Next, general administrative theory. This theory came for the purpose of managing organization. Basically, it is for the pure administrators who develop a particular organization. And Henry Fayol is the father and the guru under general administrative approaches. He developed 14 principles, and those 14 principles are very essential in managing organizations. Not only Henry Fayol, but also Max Weber developed a bureaucratic organization's structure, and he defined some ideals of bureaucracy. And those idea and ideals, both from Henry Fayol and Max Weber, developed the foundation of general administrative theory. The description of these topics can be found in the next videos, as it will increase the... Next, quantitative management approach. Under quantitative management approach, they qualify different qualitative data into the quantitative method, and based on this quantitative method, different decisions are made. In normal cases, decisions are made based on assumption, but based on the quantitative management approach, it indicates that you may use statistics, information models, computer simulation for making decisions. Basically, this concept evolved from the mathematical and statistical methods to solve military logistics and quality control problems. So the quality control issues are maintained through the quantitative management approach. The next topic is organizational behavior approach. Let's look at the what is organizational behavior. The study of actions of people at work, what people do in a particular work situation, how people are connected with each other, and in this approach, people are the most important asset of an organization. For the purpose of organizational behavior approach, early organizational behavioral advocates are Robert Owen, Hugo Munsterberg, Mary Parker Follett, Chester I. Barnard. And in the modern cases, Hawthorne studies where Elton Mayo described the modern findings on organizational behavioral approach. Next, systems approach. What is system? A system can be defined as a set of interrelated and interdependent parts arranged in a manner that produce a unified whole, that is, different interrelated parts are connected with each other, and those connected interrelated forms justify the total systems. So these systems can be closed system and open systems. Next, the contingency approach. This contingency approach, sometimes called situational approach, this indicates there is no one universally applicable set of management principles or rules by which we can manage organization. Then the question is how we can manage the organization. The solution behind this problem is that organizations are individually different. They face different situations. They require different ways of managing organization. One solution may be good for one organization, but see, this solution may not fit for me. It is because the differences between organizational science, the technology they use, the environment they work, and lot of the issues. That's why they need contingency approach, and this contingency approach suggests that in a particular situation, whichever is good for your organization, do that. The description of all these six approaches will be available in next episodes. So with this,